we can explain how any amount, but we can go on this explanation because they are very complex.
Mm.
At the same time, very serious question, political, economic, social, cultural, intellectual, many dimensions are there. So we are not going into those details. What should be our task? What should be our task? That we have to decide. Just one point. Today, we know that how this fascist threat, neo-fascism means fascism today, how this neo-fascist threat can be challenged, how it can be resisted, who can do that? From the explanation that I have made, one thing is very clear. Many people can say fascism, fascism, but who can challenge fascism? Only those who are capable of making a correct political evaluation of what is it. Because if you have to treat a disease, the diagnosis should be correct. If you are not diagnosing, if your diagnosis is not correct, your treatment will not be correct. Treatment can be correct. Treatment is efficient only if your diagnosis is correct. Therefore, we should have a correct understanding of what is going on. In that perspective, only those forces, only those revolutionary forces, communist forces, progressive forces, who are capable to analyze this situation, who are having an alternative political program, who are having an alternative political strategy, only they can lead the struggle. If not, what will happen? Suppose today many movements are there, anti-fascist movements. What will happen? Suppose BJP is lost in a particular situation, either in the state or in the center. After some time, what will happen? Congress will come or some other ruling class parties will come. They have no difference with the BJP in terms of policies. Congress has no difference. The same policy. Congress also pursue the same policy. Only difference in degree. Only difference in degree. So if the Congress comes to power, within a few days, the BJP will again succeed because they have an organization. No other party has an organization like RSS. RSS has permitted. It has gone into the roots of the country, 100 years. It has gone into each and every aspect of the country. So RSS can manipulate any party. Mohan Bhagwat, the leader of the RSS, has said, we don't want BJP. We can use any party as our political tool. BJP is only one of our tools. We can use up Kejriwal. Now Kejriwal is the B team of RSS. It is exposed to them. Who supported the CIA and these fascist policies. Even other parties, they can be used by BJP, RSS. No problem for RSS. RSS has only one agenda, establishing a Hindu Rashtra. Therefore, those parties who are proponents of neoliberalism, who are proponents of corporatization, who are proponents of the far-right policies, they cannot lead the anti-fascist struggle. Even if they defeat BJP, RSS will again come to power. Therefore, the leadership of the anti-fascist struggle should be, only the leadership can be given to those forces who are capable to put forward a political alternative. That is very important. So ideological political clarity is very important. At the same time, they alone cannot do the task, because today we know what the communists did in the second, in the interwar period, led by the communists. Fascism was defeated by joining with the even imperialist powers, because America, Britain, Soviet Union made an alliance with America and Britain to defeat Hitler and Mussolini. But Soviet Union has to lead it At that time, Soviet Union was leading the socialist world. All over the world, the communist movement was advancing. Soviet Union was leading. So Soviet Union could lead the move. Therefore, fascism was defeated. Today, such a movement should come. Only they can lead and the other ruling class parties can be tactically joined. Anti-fascist forces, because fascism is a special case. Fascism is the most reactionary terrorist section of the ruling class, that is RSS. We will not say that Congress is fascist. No, Congress is not fascist. We will not say. But Congress cannot defeat fascism, because Congress policies are neoliberal. Congress has no alternative. So therefore the communists should come forward. The progressive forces should come forward. They, the struggling left forces, should take the initiative with an alternative and led by them, anti-fascist forces can be united. Otherwise, what will happen? Fascists will again come to power. Therefore, I am concluding, our task is to build up, to develop at the top level and the bottom level. We have to build up mass political platforms. We have to build up struggling platforms of anti-fascist forces led by revolutionary left struggling forces. Otherwise, fascism cannot be defeated. Even if we see some temporary setback, fascists will again come to power. Therefore, the task is very serious and long time consuming. Not easy. It is not easy. You cannot defeat BJP by an election. You can defeat BJP in an election, but you cannot defeat RSS in an election. RSS will still remain. RSS is that much powerful. No other organization in the world is there that is so powerful that as RSS. That much power is there. It is not a simple thing. So the revolutionary forces, democratic forces, those who are with the people should think over this question very seriously, and they should come forward for a political alternative. That is only task for defeating fascism, neo-fascism. Thank you, comrades.